Have you ever thought what you would do if you just had more money or more education, or maybe you could achieve your dreams if only you lived in a different location? Folks, the question this morning is, are you using what has been given you? Good morning, folks. I'm Troy Wilson. If this is your first worship service with us, welcome. If you've already become a part of our 10 minutes of worship at 10 a.m. on Sundays, welcome back. Please join me as we take a look at what the Bible tells us concerning the using of what we have available. John chapter 6, verses 9 through 11, very short. There is a lad here which hath five barley loaves and two small fishes, but what are they among so many? And Jesus said, make the men sit down. Now there was much grass in this place, so the men sat down in number about 5,000. And Jesus took the loaves, and when he had given thanks, he distributed it to the disciples, and the disciples to them that were set down, and likewise of the fishes as much as they would. We notice here, Jesus never made the excuse of what he didn't have, but use what was available to feed the 5,000. Number one, he first gave thanks for what seemed like a little. How often do we fail to give God thanks for what we already have? So many consider themselves impoverished by today's standard. We spend far more time complaining about what we don't have than we do giving thanks for what we do have or have been given. Not just our kid folks, but us as adults also. Say amen, even though it hurts. Instead of being thankful for a job, we complain about having to work 5 days a week. I remember seeing a post at the end of last year where somebody complained about how bad 2019 was. They were hoping things would be better in 2020. Well, you got duped, my friend. Instead of being thankful for an automobile, we complain about it either being too old or too many problems, or the payment is holding us back from buying more stuff. Number two, and very important, the very next thing we noticed after Jesus gathered the available resources and after giving thanks for what he had before him, he asked God to bless it. Folks, the order of things are very important to God. Creation itself was done in an orderly manner. When God gave instructions to any of his people, it was in a specific, orderly manner. God is not going to ever bless anything until we have our own lives in order. It's hard for him to bless a mess. Hit the save button on this next one, folks. Blessings grow from what we have, not from what we want. Say it with me. Blessings grow from what we have, not from what we want. God gave me that for me, but also to share with you this morning. Folks, I must stop for a moment to thank God for sending His Holy Spirit to instill His Word. Without it, I would be wasting our time of worship together. One of my favorite songs is titled, Little Is Much When God Is In It. I will put a link to a friend of mine, Terry Henson, singing it either above or below today's message. Click on it. Each time I listen to it, I'm reminded of the many times I had little, but God blessed it and made it much. It brings to mind when I had $125 in the bank and God gave me a new house. It's true, folks. I can prove it. I recall how one phone call at a certain time on a certain day helped me provide for me and my family for the next 10 years. After putting off making the same phone call for 2 months, I later learned if I had made it on any other day at any other time, it would not have worked out. Folks, that precise timing was an absolute miracle orchestrated by God Himself. There are many more personal examples I could give you to where I have given thanks for what I had and God turned it into abundance. please permit me to tell you this short story, then I'm going to close. The building facility of a church I once pastored was leased. Our landlords were very successful people, but their business always adhered to the usual successful business model. Downside of this meant, because we were a church, it didn't entitle us to any special considerations. Let me interject, nor should it have. The month of December that particular year had left the church account almost depleted. Our church has spent much of its resources helping those who were destitute, especially those with little children who were getting little or nothing for Christmas. We gave to help others. Having faith, God would bless our endeavors and supply the money we would need for rent by December 31st. Now, I know some of you are thinking, well, Pastor Troy, would not the responsible thing to have done would make sure you had rent money before you extended help to others? Of course, in our carnal way of thinking, this would have been the proper way to handle financial matters. But we preached and believed in faith. We led other people to believe in faith. We felt God wanted us to help those he had sent our way, and we did. When it looked as though we may be short for the month, we prayed for God to supply our need. However, December 31st came with the rent due the next day and not nearly enough in the bank to write the check. As I sit with my family watching the New Year's ball drop in Times Square on TV, my heart had also begun to drop. I was silently rehearsing in my mind how I was going to approach this with my landlord the next day. It was getting late when a knock came at our front door. Apprehensive, I opened it and was shocked to see my landlord standing there in his pajamas. My first thought was, if it was an early check he was hoping for, he was about to be sadly disappointed. He handed me an envelope while telling me he and his wife felt compelled to give us this for our church. He told me his wife felt as if he should wait until the next day since it was so late. But after he had gotten dressed for bed, something just told him he should do it now. Yes, folks, our landlord had given us a check for the exact amount of money the church needed to pay him our rent the next day. He never attended our church before, neither had his wife. As a matter of fact, they were devoted supporters of the church they did attend. But when God spoke, they listened. Somebody say praise God. Why did the Holy Spirit compel him to come that night instead of the next day? Well, God not only rescued our church from eviction, but he also rescued me from a sleepless night of doubt and fear. Now, I know Christians are not supposed to do that, right? We're not supposed to doubt and have fear. Well, let me be the first to thank God for his grace and mercy, because I am all too often guilty of doing what I am not supposed to do. Folks, we in America must learn to be thankful for and use what God has given us before God is going to ever bless us with more. Let us pray. Father, we come to you this day humbling ourselves in thankfulness for all you have given us. Even greater than just the essentials needed to supply and support life, you, Father, have given us your Son, Jesus Christ, to save us from a sinful world. God, we ask if there is one within the sound of my voice who has not formed a relationship with your Son, may they be convicted by the Holy Spirit to do so at this very moment. In Jesus' name, we thank you for all things. Amen.